In this session, we'll walk through how to create a C# script that allows us to drag and drop 3D objects in Unity. The Illustrator script will assemble a small puzzle. Before you leave, hit those like and subscribe buttons. It helps the channel a lot and it's absolutely free. And as always, the link to the source code is available in the description. As an overview of how we'll be tackling this problem, first we'll cast a ray from the camera when the player left clicks. If the ray hits a specific group of objects, we'll pick it up and allow the player to move it horizontally around the screen. While moving, if a player right clicks, we'll rotate the object by 90 degrees. When the player left clicks again, we'll place the object back down. You can see we have a bunch of things in our project already, the most important thing being our puzzle pieces. I modeled these puzzle pieces in Blender and then imported them and assigned a mesh collider to them. I've also added a drag tag to them. To add a tag, click the tag dropdown and go to add tag. Hit this little plus and you can add a new tag here. We'll assign the drag tag to anything in our scene we want to drag and drop. We need a collider so that the raycast has something to hit. Depending on your use case, you could use any of the different colliders in Unity, but for simplicity, I've just decided to use the mesh collider here. We'll be doing all of the magic for our drag and drop functionality in a single script, so we just need to apply it to a single game object that won't ever be turned off. Because of the simplicity of our project, I'll just be adding it to the puzzle game object. I'll click Add Component, go to New Script, and name it Grabber. Create and add. Now we have a new script called Grabber that's attached to our puzzle game object. By default, Unity will take that script and put it in the assets folder. You'll need to assign it to the correct folder to maintain organization. As a heads up, you can also see we have this script called Puzzle Mixer. This scrambles the pieces at runtime, just so you know what's happening when we preview our game. But first, let's get to our Unity drag and drop script. I've opened my script in Visual Code, and I'm going to format it and remove the functions that I won't need. For our variables, we'll actually only need one, a private game object that will be our selected object. There's a couple different things we want to do in our update function. First, we'll want to check for left clicks. So we'll do an if input.getMouseButtonDown. 0 is the button identifier for left click. Then we will also do an if selected object is not equal to null. The thought here is that when we left click on a draggable object, we'll assign it to be the selected object. So if there is a selected object, we'll want to match our cursor position. Then when we detect another left click, we'll set the piece down and set our selected object back to null. The bulk of the work in this will come from our ray casting. There's a really great video from Holistic3D that I'll link in the description below that really details what we're doing here. So if you're interested to learn more about raycasting and what's happening, I encourage you to go check out that video. For our raycast, we'll make a separate function. It'll be private and it will return a raycast hit and we'll call it cast ray. We'll want two vector threes here, our screen mouse position far, which will be equal to a new vector 3, our input.mousePositionX, input.mousePositionY, and our camera main far clip plane. I'm going to do this again for the near clip plane. And then we'll get our screen positions to world positions. We'll do a vector 3 world mouse position far equals camera dot main dot screen to world point. And we'll take in our screen mouse position far. I'll do this again, but for the near position. Then we'll make a local raycast hit. Call it hit. Then we'll do our physics raycast. Our origin for that will be at the world mouse position near. The distance will be the difference between our far and our near. And then we'll put out our hit. A little bit of a spelling error there. There we go. And then we will return our hit. Back in our update function, I'm going to add another conditional statement. If our selected object equals null, we'll want to do one thing. That's when we'll want to assign our selected object and pick something up. If it's not, then we want to set our object down. So that's what this conditional statement will be doing. So we'll start in the selected object. So we'll make a raycast hit here. Call this hit again. It's a local variable. We'll set that equal to our cast ray function that we just made. Then we'll make a conditional statement if the hit that collider is not equal to null. We'll do a bunch of stuff. This is basically just checking, did we hit a collider? We do this check because the hit will always have information, so it won't be null. But we know that if there's no collider, it didn't collide with an actual object. Within this statement, we'll add in another conditional statement. If not collider.compare tag drag, we will return or exit this function. So what we're doing here, we're checking, we do have this collider, so we won't get a null error here. But then we want to compare the tag, but then we want to check to see if the collider has the drag tag applied to it. If it doesn't, it means it's not draggable, so we can return and just exit the function. If it is, what we need to do is assign our selected object to our hit.collider game object. As a visual quality of life improvement, because our puzzle piece will then be matching where our cursor is, we'll disable our cursor at this point as well. So this whole part here is for picking up a single new object. Now that we have our selected object, this portion of the code will be running. But then here, where our object will be dragged around. First, we'll need our screen mouse position. We'll make a local variable here, a vector3 position. Set it equal to a new vector3, where we'll use our input mouse position x, our input mouse position y, and our camera main world to screen point selected object transform position dot z. We'll convert this to a world position, camera main screen to world point position. Then we'll set our selected object transform position equal to a new vector3, which will be our world position x. Here we're going to choose 0.25. That's a flow that's going to just lift it up a little bit in the y position. And then world position z. When I click play in the editor, I can now pick up a piece and drag it along the screen. However, currently I can't drop it because we haven't built that functionality yet. Back in our script, we want to set our currently selected object down when we left click. We've already mostly built this functionality. Input get mouse button down 0 is our left click, and we have this selected object equals null. This portion of the code runs when we don't have an object selected, but when we do, this else will run. The code for this will be very similar to what we used in this selected object function. So I'll just copy this and paste it into our else. The only thing that I need to change in these three lines of code is our vertical position. So in our selected object.transform position, instead of 0.25 for our Y, we're going to set this to 0. I would like to point out that copying these three lines of code up here and making one tiny change isn't the best practice. When you realize that you're reusing parts of code, it's often beneficial to just clump everything into a function. I won't do that here, but I felt it was important to point out. The last thing that we'll need to do in this particular scenario is set our selected object back to null, and we'll re-enable our cursor. When I press preview in the editor, I can left click to pick up a piece, drag it across my screen, and left click again to drop it. The last thing I want to add in is the ability to rotate my pieces with a right click while I'm dragging them. We only want to do that when we have a selected object. So when our selected object is not equal to null, we'll do an additional check for if our input get mouse button down 1, which is the right click. Here we'll set the selected object dot transform dot rotation equal to a quaternion Euler, because they're the easiest to understand, a new vector 3, and our vector 3 will be our selected object transform rotation Euler angle x. We'll want our xyz, but for our y, we'll just add 90 to it. Now, when I playtest in the editor, I can left click to pick up an object, and while I'm dragging, right click to rotate it, and then left click again to set it down. Hopefully this video helped. If it did, please don't forget to comment down below and share this video with your friends. If you want more game development and Unity tutorials just like this, make sure to hit subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one.